Hey there, fellow travelers. Mark here with Wolters World. Today we're in Sao Paulo, Brazil, in the Parque da Luz, one of the few quiet places in this insane huge city. And today we have for you our 10 things that are going to shock you about visiting Sao Paulo. And the first thing that's going to shock you is how huge this city is. I mean, it is enormous. There's 20, 25 million people here. There's people all around you all the time. The subway and rush hour is crazy. And that's the first thing that shocks people, just how busy and how go, go, go this place is. Just the size, the sheer size of it all can be a bit much. So just be ready for that. So that might shock you, okay? Now, the second thing that's gonna shock you when you come here is people take their futebol, their soccer, their football very seriously. And they have three world-class teams here. You got Sao Paulo, Tricolore, huh? You got Palmeiras, and you got Corinthians. And people really do, it is their religion. Yes, I know they say Catholicism or evangelical stuff here in Brazil, but look, here, there's three religions. You got Sao Paulo, you got Corinthians, or you've got Palmeiras. That's what people really cheer for. So don't make too many jokes about the soccer teams. And on game days, if you're a tourist, don't wear a jersey. Other days you'll be fine, but on game day, maybe best not to do too much. The third thing that's gonna shock you about Sao Paulo is that actually they have fancied up the mortadella sandwich, or they fancied up bologna. Going to the Mercado Municipal is one of the best experiences you can have here. And it's shocking how friendly and outgoing the people are there. They'll be giving you, here, try this fruit, try fruit you've never heard of. I'm like, I don't even know what this is. They're just try it. Have natural chocolate strawberries where it's figs and strawberries together. I mean, it is fantastic, and you'll be shocked how fun it is there. But the funniest thing is, you'll be shocked, is how they really do make a bologna sandwich actually quite fancy. Now, the fourth thing that's gonna shock you when you come here is the traffic. Remember, the first thing is how big this thing is. With those 20, 25 million people, they're driving around, and the traffic here is insane. Be ready for white knuckle taxi rides where you're weaving in between big trucks and bulldozers and the moto boys, the guys on the motorcycles flying by and knocking the side mirrors off your car. Why not? It is crazy, okay? And that will shock you, is that traffic that goes by, because it can be a bit much. And that leads into the fifth thing that's gonna shock you is the dudes that want you to pay because you parked. And you'll see that if you're gonna be driving around, or if you're coming with some locals to park, you'll see these guys say, oh, come over here, I got a spot right here for you. And you get out and you gotta pay these guys a few reais. And the thing is, you're like, why do I need to pay the guy? It's free parking, or I park, pay at the meter. It doesn't matter. You gotta pay these guys. Otherwise, something bad might happen to your car. I'm just saying, so be ready for that one, okay? Now, the sixth thing that's gonna shock you when you come here is the fact that you're gonna get sushi with your steak. When you go to the rodízio, you know, the Brazilian meat place where they cut the meat off, they bring it all around, they'll actually have sushi things there as well, because there's a million people with Japanese ancestry here in Sao Paulo. You want Lebanese food? They have some of the best Lebanese food in the world. Italian food? They got some of the best Italian food in the world. And that's what's cool about here. You're gonna be shocked is how like many cultures are here, because this really is the melting pot of Brazil, and you're gonna have that great influences all around. So you're gonna see people from all kinds of ethnicities here, all kinds of nationalities, and it's really cool. And you're shocked, because wow, I'm gonna have the best Lebanese food of my life. Well, yeah, because there's more Lebanese people here than anywhere else. And it is just really kind of a cool thing here. And it is kind of shocking how much great international flair you do have here. So make sure you check out the Immigration Museum here in Sao Paulo, so you can learn about the immigration from people coming from all over Europe and all over the world here. It is really kind of a cool thing. The seventh thing that might shock you when you come here is they actually have a snake research park you can go to and see all kinds of crazy snakes here that, yes, could probably kill you and would actually kill you if they could, you know. But also that's where they actually figure out the anti-venoms and stuff. It is kind of a cool kind of place to stop at and see if you are here. And that's one of those kind of, oh my God, there's a snake park. Yes, there is. And you can go check it out. And my mom literally was about to have a heart attack when we even mentioned the place. So she obviously did not go last time we were here, okay? The eighth thing that shocks tourists when they come here is there's no beach in Sao Paulo. When people think of Brazil, they think of more like Rio and Bahia and the Northeast, where there's sun and beach and outside and the bikinis and all those kind of things. Look, Sao Paulo is not a beach town. Sao Paulo is a culture town. There's tons of museums, the MASP. You got to go there. If you want your impressionist European art and famous Brazilian art, they have that there. If you want to go see, if you want to see some of the Atlantic rainforest, they actually have it across the street. You can go see that. There's all kinds of great cultural centers here, all kinds of great museums. Like I said, the Immigration Museum, the Futebol Museum, the Football Museum, the Soccer Museum here. That's what shocks people. No, it's not a beach place, Brazil here. It's a culture place, which is really cool, okay? So the food and the eating and the shopping and the museums and the culture, really kind of cool. And the business that really goes on here, because this is the business center, the business heart of Brazil. Now, the ninth thing that's going to shock you when you come here is the crime in Brazil. No, I'm not just talking about government bureaucracy and government, you know, corruption and stuff like that. I'm talking about actual crime. You really need to be careful when you do come here. Notice I'm not wearing my wedding ring or a fancy watch and stuff like that. You really need to pay attention when you are here. Don't leave stuff in your car. Don't walk around with lots of bling on. Look, here in Sao Paulo, people do dress better than other parts of Brazil, but you do got to be careful because you will be shocked how much crime does come here. You know, we've heard stories of people in their cars driving around, they're stuck in traffic, and one of the motor boys come by, smashes the back window, takes their briefcase out of the back seat and go. So just be careful because there is crime that is here. I mean, don't be crazy, but you really need to pay attention with your watch, wallet, and all those things. So don't dress too much up. We've got videos on how to be safe when you are here in Brazil. And the 10th thing you're gonna love about coming to Sao Paulo are the people. The Paulistanos are awesome. They will give you the shirt off their back. They will show you a great time. They'll take you to these great restaurants, take you to the Mercado Municipal. They're gonna do all kinds of great stuff with you. And they really are passionate about their city and showing the city and loving the city. And that's one of the cool things about having such a huge, amazing world city, that the people are so cool and so much fun. So if you do get a chance, get to Sao Paulo. Is it the best, greatest, awesomest place for a tourist? Maybe not, but it's worth coming to see. It's just because of all the stuff that is here with the culture, the shopping, the eating, and all kinds of stuff, and the people. So if you want to learn more, like 5 things you're going to love and hate about coming here, or 10 facts about Sao Paulo, or 5 things you love and hate about coming to Brazil, check us out on our website at wolters.com. We're also on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and we really appreciate your likes, subscriptions, and we hope you have a great time. And watch out for the mosquitoes because they're getting Jocelyn. That's why she's holding the camera and it's going like this. So, adeus from Brazil.
Sorry, y'all.